Hey guys, are you getting sound that sounds a little bit like that? Clicks and pops, my friend. Clicks and pops. That's what we're talking about today, and we're going to try and fix that up for you. Okay? All right, I'll see you inside. Okay, so there's a lot of reasons on a computer why you would have clicks and pops. Look at this. My CPU is smashed right now. If I click on that, look at that. That's insane. And every time I talk, even, it just gets worse. So the first thing that you might do if you're experiencing this sound is look at that. Look at your CPU. It's just trashed right now. It's filled up. And so in this case, what I would do is hit command comma, bring up the options, and look at that. I'm operating at 64 samples, and I know I got a slew of plugins in there. So turn that all the way up, okay? Apply. And once it's done, that should fix it in itself. If that doesn't fix it, there's a couple other things you can do, but I would say a lot of times with beginners in audio, digital audio, that's what it's gonna be. So totally different song, right? Okay, if that didn't fix it and you're still having issues, there's one thing, a feature of Bitwig that you should be aware of, and it's called the sandboxing feature. And what that is when a plugin that isn't made by Bitwig, see, this is made by Bitwig, and so it has a feature built in that suspends it when it's not receiving any audio at all, okay? And that's great. Bitwig's devices are designed so that that happens fluently, but exterior plugins like this one here are not made to be suspended. Well, some of them are, a lot of the new ones are, and so they'll suspend just fine, but I would say go through your track, open it up, and go through any exterior plugins you might have and just right click, auto suspend, off. Play the track back, listen to it. If the click doesn't go away, go to the next plugin, off. Right click, auto suspend, turn it off, listen again, and then keep doing that until all your external plugins are turned to no auto suspend. Okay, well, as soon as it's fixed, remember that plugin, and remember every time you use that plugin to just automatically right click and auto suspend off. For me, I know that this is one of my favorite reverbs. It sounds great. It's very manipulatable. But I know that every time I use it, I automatically have to set it to off. See, it's already set off because it just does not like to be suspended, okay? It's like that goody two shoes in high school, right? Where like he never smoked pot and then he's just like, I just want to get good grades. I just want to do my homework, right? Like he just wants to work for you, and that's awesome. I mean, at this point in life, you look back and go, well, damn, why did I smoke so much pot and why didn't I try to not get suspended? But that's besides the point, okay? Let's not go down that road. Just realize that some plugins, they don't like to be suspended, and so we'll give them that luxury by right-clicking, again, auto-suspend, off, and then just do that and try it out. If you still have problems after that and you're on a Mac, well, I can guarantee you that it has something to do with your MIDI. Well, I can't guarantee that, but click the little magnifying glass here, type in MIDI, hit enter, and there we go. Let's bring this up. Now, I can't explain to you what you're gonna have to do in here so well because I don't know your setup, okay? And also, I'm just not an expert in this. But depending on what you're using as far as devices, if you have a bunch of aggregates and multi-devices and stuff like that, make sure your sample rates are all set up. Okay, make sure there's not conflictions in here. Make sure you're not duplicating things. You don't have a whole, like a huge list in there. Just use what you typically, just pare it down to what you typically use. Make sure the sample rates are set up properly, and you're just gonna have to troubleshoot on your own. It may be a phone call to Mac as to figuring that out. You could email me on this, but I don't know how much help I'll honestly be in regards to this stuff. But just recognize that this a lot of times is a source of some problems, especially if you have Pro Tools. Oh my God, Pro Tools. If you're on OS X Yosemite like I am right here, I'm sorry. It's the worst, isn't it? I hate it so much, but I don't want to update it because Pro Tools is like, you know what? It's like when you were a kid and you had your 14-year-old sister, right? And your parents went out for the night and then they left her the keys and all the grocery money or whatever. And you're like, you're just like, oh man, I'm starving. Like, just give me some cash. Or whatever, let's get a pizza. And she's like, no, not until you do my dishes. Or something. That's Pro Tools, okay? Pro Tools is your 14-year-old sister on the worst rag of her life, okay? Because Pro Tools just takes over your Mac. It just takes friggin' over. And so I had a huge problem where the Pro Tools core audio driver that they gave me with Pro Tools 12 was outdated, didn't work well with OS X Yosemite, okay? And so I contacted Pro Tools and said, well, can I have the new one, the one that you guys sent out to fix it? And they're like, no, you have to buy the new Pro Tools. And I'm like, well, no, because it's like $1 million, right? I already paid for it once. Just give me the damn plugin. And they didn't. So I just went on to Google. I typed in the plugin. I think it was like coreaudio.plugin 12.6, whatever the hell. And someone else graciously put it up on their Dropbox. And I downloaded it from there, installed it. No problem since then. If you don't have Pro Tools, then you probably don't have that problem. But that's just something that you should be aware of with Yosemite and Pro Tools. And I'm sure now that Sierra is out, I'm sure it has its own inherent problems with Pro Tools, because Pro Tools doesn't play nice, okay? It's a geezer. I love it, but I really hate it. And so you're just going to have to play around inside here, okay? That's basically the gist of it. Update your Pro Tools aggregate plugin or your core audio plugin if you need to. If you're not worried about Pro Tools and other things, maybe update your OS X. I would do it if I didn't have Pro Tools and I didn't have all these plugins and I wasn't worried about it. If I could start fresh, I would totally be up to date on my OS X. So if you can do that route, I would definitely do it, because now if I call Mac about Yosemite, they're like, sorry, we don't support Yosemite, right? They're great. Yeah, real great. Thanks, guys. So just make sure there's no conflictions here, and that, like, see, this is on 44.1, which is terrible. I don't know why that. Oh yeah, that's because I made a video where I set it to 44.1. Damn it, now I got it. All right. Well, anyway, if that doesn't work, there are some other things you can do. And this is, again, if you're on a Mac, click go, hold option, go to library, okay? Go down to Bitwig Studio, applications, take these three guys right here and drag them onto your desktop. Sorry, close Bitwig and then drag these onto your desktop, okay? Restart your computer, open Bitwig, open your project, listen to it. If the problem is fixed, go back in here, verify that these have been recreated by Bitwig, delete the ones off of your desktop, okay? I know that sounds weird, okay? So let me go through this again. Close Bitwig, click go, hold option, go to library, okay? Application support, Bitwig Studio, application, grab these three, drag them onto the desktop, close this up, restart your computer, open Bitwig, open your project, listen to it. If it's fixed, come back in here. This will already be opened again. Make sure that it's recreated these three and verify that. And then you know the three on your desktop, you can delete them, toss them in the trash, get rid of that shit, okay? And so those are all the things that I've had to do in the past to fix any clicks and pops inside of Bitwig. For the most part, 99% of the time when my friends ask me why they're getting clicks and pops, I can just go into the settings and I can see that they have this thing way over there. They're asking too much of their computer, and most of the time they're not even recording live audio or live MIDI at the time. They're just mixing or working with samples, and in that case, just put it all the way over there, and that gives your computer lots of breathing room. And secondly, of course, the good boys here, this Akon digital reverb, that doesn't want to be suspended, and I just figured that out, like I just said earlier, and learn to turn that off every time you use it, okay? And that's 99% of the problems that you're going to incur Other than that, if you're in the MIDI settings of the Mac and you've deleted that and nothing seems to be working, it sounds like a phone call to Bitwig, or not a phone call, sorry, an email to Bitwig. But before you email them, you need to type out like an extensive list. You got to take an inventory of everything that you have on your computer, okay? Like everything. You got to tell them what's the let's see. Give them all that shit, okay? Everything like that. Give them your computer specs, your hardware specs, what plugins you use, what version of Bitwig are you using, what's the buffer size you're setting it at, like everything. What color underwear are you wearing at the time of the email, okay? And I did this. I sent them an email with such a huge list of stuff. I sent them the email, and then they emailed me back, "We need some more information." I'm like, holy shit. And they're like, "Do you use an external keyboard?" And I was like, "Yeah, actually I do. I just bought this piece of junk off of it, yeah, off of Amazon, and it was a Mac external keyboard, so I kind of perch my laptop up there when I'm on the go, and then I have the number pads, which I like to use for Pro Tools." And I sent it back. Yes, it's this kind of keyboard. It's like some Chinese name that no one anywhere can pronounce. And then they email me back like within the day, and they're like, "Oh, your whatever key is sticking on your, like, just unplug your external keyboard." I unplugged my external keyboard and it fixed it, okay? It wasn't clicks and pops that I was dealing with at that time, but it fixed it. And I was thinking, like, what kind of an analytical problem-solving brain do you guys have that you can read through my like 8,000 paragraphs of text and be like, "Oh, it's probably just a sticky key on his external keyboard," right? How did they know? I don't know. They're Germans too, right? Like, have you ever driven a Volkswagen? My God, those things are awesome, right? It's like driving a tank. All right. Well, anyway, enough for that. You didn't come here to hear me rant. I'm just saying that Bitwig's going to help you out, man. They're good. Ever since then, I was like, damn, these guys are great. And that's what I like about them. They're a small enough company that they still have to work hard, and they sure do. All their updates are great. And their support is unbelievable. Okay, like within a day, I'm talking. So anyway, give them some notice. Give them the extensive list of everything that you use, and they'll be able to help you out. Okay, all right, guys. I hope this helps you out, because it's so demotivating to get clicks and pops, and I know that. And so we'll work on it together. If you have any other cures for this, specifically Windows, because I don't use Windows. Like, I have Windows on my Mac, but I don't use it, and I couldn't problem solve that for you. Leave them in the comment section below, and that way when people come to this video and they're having problems, they can go down there and kind of see if anyone else has posted any solutions. Other than that, you're kind of left with going to the KVR forums, the Bitwig Q&A section, and those are pretty helpful too. Okay, all right, guys, please subscribe to my channel. I would really like for you to do that. You know what it's like? It's like you were driving down the road and you got a flat tire and you pulled over, right? And you open your trunk and you're like, shit, the jack's broken. And then I see you struggling. You're kind of walking around your car like, shit, fuck. And so I stop and I go, "Don't worry, man, like, have a smoke, chill out." And then I have a jack in my car, and then together we jack up your car, fix the tire, right? That's like me making this video right now, okay? And then the next day you see me, I'm pulled over, my flat tire is flat, I don't have a spare, and my cell phone's dead or something. And then you drive up and you see me, you go, "Hey, that's the dude that helped me yesterday," right? So what do? Then do you click subscribe, right? Are you the guy that's like, "You know what, I'll pull over, lend this guy my phone, he can call roadside assistance," and I'm like, "Oh, I recognize you, man, thank you, blah blah blah," right? And then we both are home before dinner and everything's hunky-dory. Or are you the guy that's like, "Sorry, man, I'm in a rush," and then you don't click subscribe and you just take off? You know, well, I guess it's not that dramatic, really. It's not. Just whatever, I don't know. I would like for you to subscribe, I'm just saying. Okay, guys. All right. Well, even if, whether you do or don't subscribe, I hope you take care of yourself. I hope you do a lot of Bitwigging, okay? And if you ever want to come back, we'll be here. We'll be wigging out hard on Bitwig, and I hope you can join us. All right? Okay, kids. Take care.